Thank you very much. Can you hear me? Yes. Yeah. When I heard Stan's presentation, I realized that my presentation is about something totally different than I thought it was. My presentation is about putting things into an FM context. In my case, it's about putting information systems into an FM context. And for that purpose, we need the standards. So that's what I thought while I heard Stan. Okay. My name is Poul Ebbesen. I'm a consultant in the consulting company called Ramboll, and I'm primarily engaged in projects related to information technology and facilities management. 1 year ago, I finished my PhD project with the title Adding Value to FM with IT. I did my PhD project in a rather late age, but I found it very, very fun. The paper I will present for you is part of my PhD. The title is Assessing the Added Value of IS Supporting FM Business Processes. The title is way too long, I'm sorry. In my project, I investigated several cases of how IS diffuses into FM organizations. In each case, I asked FM employees and managers about their perception of the value being added from the IS being implemented. And what really surprised me was the lack of clarity and focus on the concept of value. For me, only a part of the value picture was expressed. For the respondents, it was unclear what part of the supply chain in FM that should benefit from the information system being implemented. And I realized that we need a method for assessing the added value. And this is what my paper is about. It's about a method I would suggest for this purpose. I will present you for the elements constituting the method, the three steps in the method, some use value concepts and IS concepts. I will explain how use value, cost of service, and cost of IS implementation develops over time. And I will exemplify the method using a case. Finally, I will present some conclusions and my recommendations. I hope you find it interesting and useful. I can say I find it very useful in my daily work. This figure illustrates the different elements in the method. The elements are concepts and models from different disciplines: FM, business management, ethics, and information systems. First of all, the value dimensions suitable for describing the value of business processes are included. And I have chosen efficiency and effectiveness and also interoperability, but I could have chosen a lot other dimensions. Secondly, the concepts of functional affordances. Functional affordances are potential uses of IS based on the user's interpretation. Next, and here is the core. Next, the FM supply chain model is included. And that's the way I get my assessment into the FM context. Finally, I use the value-added management model. The method is supposed to be very simple. It's not supposed to be complex. It includes some, I think, quite complex or complicated concepts, but the method in itself is very easy to use. It consists of three steps. In the first step, the IS case is analyzed using the FM supply chain model. In step two, increase in efficiency and improvements in effectiveness as of the result of the IS being implemented is assessed. Finally, in step 3, the degree or level of value-added management is assessed. There are no common definition of value. In this paper, value is understood as benefits to the business. Examples of benefits from implementing IS can, as shown in the figure, be efficiency, effectiveness, and interoperability. But I could, as mentioned before, also have chosen other dimensions. The right side of the figure shows that IS can offer functional affordances, some of which can improve the value dimensions. This figure illustrates an ideal, very ideal, relative development over time in cost and use value of an FM service, initiated as a result of an IS implementation process. An increase in use value will occur if the customer satisfaction over time gets higher. So we see an increase in use value, the customer gets more satisfied, hopefully. We see a reduction in cost, maybe, maybe not. And we see a lot of money being spent on implementing the information system. And that's the hump shape curve in the bottom. It represents the investment. When we assess the added value, we should of course ask whether the increase in efficiency and so on is worth the effort. This is the effort. Is it worth adding a little more use value or reducing the cost a little bit? I mean, this is resources spent. So we have to consider that, of course. But I'm not looking at return of investment. That's not my point. In the case used to exemplify the method, the IS is intended to support cleaning in a big airport in Europe. The IS delivers information about frequency of use of specific rooms. The frequency of use is monitored by use of sensors. Furthermore, the IS includes a use response system, enabling users to report about their experience of using the rooms. This information system enables the cleaning organization to do cleaning based on demand rather on routine. I mean, that's just saying that indicates that maybe there's a good business case here. If you go back, I mean, they invest money and they could maybe reduce the cost. They don't do cleaning just regularly, they only do it on demand. So that could be a good thing to do. But the question is, what about the use value? Users are asked quarterly about their experience of using the rooms. So if we go back again, users are asked quarterly, so over time we will know if the users get more satisfied. Okay. This may be a quite confusing figure. I have allowed myself to take a copy from the taxonomy standard number 4 and simply take the case and analyze the case using this this figure. And I find it's the maybe the main point of assessing whether technology or whatever we implement, the changes we make. We have to see it in this context if we are dealing with FM. So this is step one. I use the supply chain model. On the supply side, over here, the IS is used by the dispatcher from the cleaning company. The SLA-related part of the contract requires the dispatcher from the cleaning company to send out personnel when needed, based on the information from the IS system. And on the demand side, over here, the manager responsible for cleaning at the airport monitors the cleaning, also based on the information system. So it's on both the supply and on the demand side that the information system is used. By use of the surveys, the quarterly surveys, the user experience is investigated quarterly. So that's down here. So this just, I know it's a quite confusing figure, but it should illustrate that this enables me to understand how the system affects this demand-supply picture. One thing that this does not show, though, is that the use of the IS to support the cleaning process is aligned with the strategy of improving cleaning and thereby contributing to reach the goal of being the best airport. So the airport management has a goal of becoming the best airport, at least in Europe, and one of the strategies is to improve the facilities. So this is aligned with the strategy. We cannot directly see that from this figure. We need some other kind of illustration to illustrate that. In step two, the efficiency effectiveness is assessed. Since the introduction of the IS, the quality of the cleaning has improved, as I mentioned, and the cost of the cleaning has not increased. Therefore, the effectiveness of the cleaning has improved. At the same time, the experience level of cleaning, has increased, according to the quarterly surveys, at least. The improvements in effectiveness has led to improvements in the output and outcome, thereby leading to added use value. So we have a case here where we can see added use value. Finally, in the last step three, we put our result into this very simple figure developed by Jensen and his colleague Kachamat. I'm sorry if I pronounced the name wrong. As we saw before, the IS support effectiveness. It delivers information so the cleaning dispatcher can better initiate right cleaning. Thereby, IS improves the effect of the cleaning process. Up here. Improved effectiveness. The IS also supports efficiency. The cleaning dispatcher can better initiate cleaning when needed, thereby reducing the resources spent on cleaning. I mentioned before that the cost of the cleaning has not changed. So who's actually collecting the benefit? I think it's the cleaning company. If you look at the money, I think they do the same cleaning, but use less money. But for the airport, this was not a matter of saving money. This was a matter of doing something that's aligned with the strategy. And I think that's a quite important point. Okay. I think the method illustrates that a well-organized management setup is required to gain value from IS. What I experience in my daily work is, I must admit, I see some cases where you invest in IS, but you don't have this clear picture of how do we actually add value to the supply chain, or even worse, how do we actually support some kind of strategy of the company. The IAS in this case keeps track of the state of the cleaning and can be used by the demand side to monitor the quality of the delivery of cleaning. So as I mentioned before, it's not only the supply side, it's also the demand side that benefits from this, which I find quite interesting that we are partners, we have suppliers and we have demand side, and both sides should benefit from whatever we implement, at least when it's technology, or we should try to. Finally, I will give you some very, very simple recommendations. I can remind you all, if all of you who are involved in things like this, try the method when you need to assess the added value of an existing information system or a new information system being implemented. And I will be happy to help. You can reach me on this mail address or on it@fm.com. I will also be happy to receive recommendations for improvements of the method. It lacks things. It's not complete, you could say, but it's useful as it is. Finally, thank you very much for listening.
Thank you very much. So.